A prototype of a new fighter jet has been unveiled in Russia at the MAX 2021 International Aviation and Space Salon. Russian President Vladimir Putin inspected the prospective warplane, showcased with considerable fanfare. The air show opened Tuesday in Zhukovsky, outside Moscow. The fighter's been developed by Sukhoi under the LTS, or Light Tactical Aircraft, program. Its makers said the prototype is set to make its maiden flight in 2023, and deliveries could start in 2026. Russian state corporation Rostec, which includes Sukhoi and other aircraft makers, has advertised the new fighter under the tag Checkmate. Viewers may note, Russia is one of the world's few countries that has the expertise to manufacture a fighter from start to finish. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what we know about the Sukhoi-designed, Russia's newest fighter jet. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. This is the first single-engine Russian fighter built since the Cold War. This is the only fighter jet touted to be fifth-generation aircraft to have a single engine apart from the American F-35. It's likely that eventually the fighter will be powered by new generation Izdalai 30 engine, which is being developed. Initial prototypes may well be flown with AL-41F1 turbofan, which is used in the Sukhoi Su-57. Izdalai 30 is expected to produce around 16 to 17 tons of thrust, compared to the AL-41F1 that produces around 14.5 tons of thrust. Both the Izdalai 30 and AL-41F1 feature thrust vectoring. The Russian fighter will reportedly have a max speed of Mach 2 and a range of 3,000 kilometers, or 1,864 miles. It will possess supercruise and supermaneuverability. Supercruise is the ability to have sustained supersonic flight without having to use the highly inefficient afterburners. With this, the fighter will be able to intercept targets that subsonic aircraft would lack the speed to pursue, and an afterburner-dependent aircraft would lack the fuel to catch. This is something that's not available in American F-35. Currently, China's J-10C is the only single-engine fighter to have this. Aided with thrust vectoring nozzles and a highly optimized design, the aircraft will also be super maneuverable, making it an excellent dogfighter. According to the TASS article from last May, the jet being developed by Sukhoi can be a universal platform in manned and unmanned versions. It's imaginable that unmanned or optionally manned variants of the aircraft will be available. The technology is most likely being leveraged from S-70 Akhotnik unmanned combat air vehicle. The Akhotnik, meaning hunter, is a Russian stealth heavy unmanned combat aerial vehicle, UCAV, being developed by Sukhoi and Russian aircraft corporation MiG as a sixth generation aircraft project. The drone is based on the earlier Mikoyan Scat, designed by MiG, and encompassing some technologies of the fifth-generation Sukhoi Su-57 fighter jet. It's expected to enter service with the Russian Armed Forces by 2025. The new aircraft will also have a two-seater variant. Russia is the world's second-largest arms exporter, and weapons sales are one of the major avenues for foreign revenue inflows. The aircraft seems to be positioned for export. The pitch of Su-57 to the Foreign Air Force has failed, including in India, which was initially pouring in money for the development of the fighter. The fighter will have a lower cost and hence see interest from other nations. Interestingly, Rostec's branding at the Moscow Air Show for the fighter is all in English, indicating the target audience is a foreign market, not the Russian Ministry of Defense. Even some of the videos promoting the fighter feature pilots from other countries. The fighter is developed to be low observable. It's built around a radar cross-section, reducing stealth profile. The fighter is developed with an external structure design that deflects the radar signals away from the emitting radar. Also, reports indicate that the aircraft will have a coating of radar-absorbing material, RAM. RAM will make sure that radar signals are absorbed and don't reflect back to the source. F-22 has an RCS, or radar cross-section, of only 0.0001 square meter, while F-35 Lightning II has an RCS of 0.005 square meter. As per some analysis, Su-57 has an RCS of 0.05 square meter, which makes it around 500 times larger on the radar when compared to F-22, and at least 10 times when compared to F-35. The expectation is that the new fighter will improve on this. Rostec shared an image of what appeared to be an infrared sensor. Rostec tweeted that the black cases are very tempting, but the details are always more interesting, and used the hashtag checkmate. It's expected that the fighter will be equipped with an advanced infrared suite similar to the electro-optical targeting system, EOTS, of the F-35. Mounted under the fuselage of the F-35, EOTS has forward-looking infrared, FLIR, and infrared search and track, IRST, functions. FLIR is meant to detect targets on the surface based on their heat signature, while IRST is meant to detect aircraft, etc., in the air. EOTS includes a laser targeting system to guide laser-guided bombs. It's to be noted here that EOTS is a passive sensor that does not alert an enemy, unlike a radar when it's locked, and hence is crucial for stealth aircraft.